The north and east shores of Samos are littered with splashes of orange. These are the life jackets refugees leave when they land on the island after a grueling crossing in total darkness that takes several hours. What they need first is to make a fire to warm themselves up and show where they are. Then it's to the harbour, Vati, where the police will provide them with a pass that will enable them to continue their journey. MSF asks locals to let them know when they see boats approaching so they can assist the refugees as quickly as possible.
I've just had a call from a volunteer telling me that a boat has just arrived. So I'm on my way with first aid supplies and water and biscuits too. Once the refugees are all okay and back on their feet, they'll be taken to the harbour.
When the MSF nurse arrives to offer first aid to refugees who have just landed, Gabby, a volunteer who lives on the island, is usually already there. She hands out dry clothes, water and biscuits to the families and toys and cakes to the children. Gabby and a dozen others have been helping out since the summer. Incapable of standing by as 1,000 or so people a day arrive on the island, they decided to get organised.
Yeah, we just try to be there as fast as possible so we can help also to pull the boat on land, helping the people out, say one welcome, one melaba, and then try to do whatever we can to give them the first help. We have some people here from the village who just pass by every day and ask, can we help? So we pack some diapers, we collect some toys from the children. So the group is constantly growing.
The bus hired by MSF then takes the latest arrivals to Vati Harbour. There are around 2,000 people here, waiting for permits. It takes at least 4 or 5 days, but often more. The lucky ones go to hotels, while the others sleep here in containers, tents or on the ground. All they want is to continue their journey.
My plan was going to Netherlands, frankly. I'll go there. But you know, there are a lot of steps before you reach Netherlands. It's a long trip, but I'll make it. I get afraid because I hear the rumor that they will not let us to go to which country that we want to go. But I hope it will be a lie, not the truth.
Spaghetti. Meanwhile, groups of volunteers get together in the morning and at noon to distribute food to the refugees. Since the beginning of August, Yokesti has been cooking meals for several hundred people every day.
We start to cook for 30 persons, only 30. We go there and the other day we cook for 60 meals, 100 meals, 200 meals, 300 and 4,000, you know.
Once they get the white piece of paper authorizing them to continue their journey, the refugees board the ferry to Athens. The crossing takes 9 hours. This is just the beginning of a long trek. Buses await them to take them to the border with Macedonia. Then it's Serbia, Croatia. They move fast. They know Europe is closing its borders, and turning back is quite simply not an option.